I think that I probably have one of the coolest jobs on the planet. I get to play every day with color, light, imagination, perception, and connectivity. This is what I get from my street paintings. I first discovered street painting back in 1997 at the Santa Barbara E. Modinari Street Painting Festival. I had stumbled upon it by accident, and I couldn't believe what I saw there. Artists were drawing amazing and beautiful dynamic pieces of artwork with chalk pastels on the pavement. I thought, wow, this is my tribe. I need to join these people. So the following year, I signed up and made my first painting. Now, what I love most about 3D artwork is that it, I always get a laugh with this one. It's an ephemeral, performance-oriented art form in that it only lasts for a few days or a few hours even, because weather and environment are largely impactful onto the artwork. So it makes it very precious to me. It makes the process very precious to me. And it really has taught me how to let go of expectations and another funny one. It's really taught me how to let go in a lot of areas in my life, and I value that greatly. The other aspect is the performance aspect, and it really has taken me, the artist, out of my isolated studio environment to you, the public, which for some reason I really enjoy. Like the dialogue that happens between us and the interaction, it's very important to me. So a couple of years into my drawing, I was doing traditional Renaissance pieces, and I thought, you know, this pavement is offering something else to me. There's a world here that needs to be explored, and I'm going to do it. So I started practicing with 3D compositions. And at that time, there was no one teaching. There were no schools, no blog articles, no workshops. Where was I going to learn? Well, I went back to my Renaissance studies and found Andrea del Pozzo, who was a master in anamorphic projection from the Baroque era. I read all of his books. And I also contacted math professors in places like Mexico City who were experts in modular perspective. And these things helped me learn how to create the devices and the rules that I need to follow in order to make a successful 3D piece. Well, that all sounded really great, and I did practice that for a few years. But I kept feeling like there was something missing. There was a psychological space still between myself and you guys, the viewers, the public. So this is when I delved into interactive pieces. I started designing compositions that would allow for you to actually step into my imaginary world. Thus, you would complete my painting for me. It would cease to be mine and would become ours. So some of the rules that I played with were I'd photograph scenes, I'd photograph places that I'd want to draw, I'd have my friends model for me, begrudgingly sometimes. I'd please stand in that position and stay there for about 5 minutes. But it was a lot of fun. I did make a lot of mistakes along the way, but the successes were truly magical. And what I found happening at that time was that I began traveling around the world to make these drawings. People seemed to be interested in them, which was mind-blowing to me. And I would have you, the audience or public, come up to me and ask me, how did you do that? What were you thinking? Where do your ideas come from? So I would explain to them what I was thinking at the time. Sometimes I work from sketches, sometimes I work from photographs, and sometimes I work from my imagination. I might just switch gears in the middle of a painting. Just whatever comes over me at the time. And yes, I'm having fun on the pencil here. Anyway, I thought, wow, there's a real need for understanding about what I'm doing. So as a part of my appearances worldwide, I began developing workshop components where I would teach people what I was doing. And I've been able to travel to places like India and China, all over the world, where I can actually teach people how to get down and be creative with their own imagination. They're not reliant on me. I just give them the tools so they can expand on their own. I've also worked in multi-dimensional surfaces. Here you can see a wall and a floor piece, which is a lot of fun. And sometimes I work in large pieces with groups. This was a piece that required 6 days, about 5 people to work on this. It's a large mousetrap. Anyway, as you can see, I have a lot of fun with my pieces. I think the playful humor comes out in my work. And this is actually a workshop piece done by students of mine in India, which I think was fantastic. So as you can see, I am an example of someone that surely has the world in their grasp. I stumbled upon this art form by accident. I opened my heart, took a risk, allowed myself to play, and found a way to merge my inner world with the outer, larger global community. Hope you enjoy it. Please come see my painting. Thank you.